Good evening, and welcome to the 2022 NBA Draft at Barclays Center.
It must have been around maybe like 16, 17, where I was like, yeah, this is, you know, I have a good chance if I keep working, stay consistent and grow, like anything's possible.
You know, I was just using my imagination, playing against the best players in the league at the time. And, you know, I'm here now, so it's a blessing. LeBron, KD, Kyrie.
Allen Iverson, Kobe, Jordan. So just seeing them play, you know, that was my dream, being in the NBA.
With the 9th pick, the San Antonio Spurs select Jeremy Sochan. With the 20th pick, the San Antonio Spurs select Malaki Branham. With the 25th pick, the San Antonio Spurs select Blake Wesley.
Now y'all together.
Exactly. It was meant to be.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, my heart was racing so fast. I mean, I'm so happy, and it's just such a blessing, you know.
I've been dreaming about this since a little kid. Just really excited, and I can't wait to be in this elite group of, you know, players, and just keep on working.
That's what I wanted. You know, I'm just blessed to be at the green room, blessed to be able to walk across the stage and shake the commissioner's hand. So I'm just happy. I'm just living in the moment.
I mean, after the workout, I was telling my dad, I love the Spurs. I want to go to the Spurs. I didn't really care what number I went, as long as the team right fit for me, and the Spurs was right fit for me.
And to be in San Antonio Spurs is a blessing. So I wore the white and black for the Spurs. So, yeah.
Spurs, man, you're going to love me.
We spend as much time teaching them how to drive as we do teaching them how to play defense.
So. We still need our driving license. Yeah. So.
As we talked about the other day, we approach every draft trying to find the best available talent. And we walked away from this one feeling really good about what we ended up with. You know, we don't spill the whole board, but, you know, we had all three guys with draft grades inside of 20. And so to be able to get all three of them with our three picks in the first round, we're really excited about that.
Yeah, it's definitely different from college. It's a little faster. I would say, you know, bigger guys, so it's more difficult. Hey, my guy.
Sprinkles, you up here telling the truth?
Yeah, of course, never. Never lies, man.
I think he's meshed well. Like I said, I mean, with the four units, we've only been two games, but the way he plays, like I said, he's all over the court. He's an all-around player, and he helps us out on both ends of the floor, so.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy to kind of think of it like that. I don't even think I'm playing, you know, my first game in a couple of days. But it's, you know, just trying to take it all in, if that makes sense, yeah.
I feel like all those guys are pretty cool. You know, it makes it easy for me trying to be a big brother to them because those guys are so level-headed and they want to learn every step of the way.
As a rookie class, it was good for me, Malaki, and Jeremy. Just getting the feel for it first day. Just learning a lot of stuff. Everything not going to be perfect first day. That's why we got a whole week to learn. But overall, went good today.
You know, your rookie season is tough, for sure. But, you know, we have some good vets. And me, KJ, Trey, some of the young guys, some of the young vets, as you could call it. We've been in their ear. We've been helping them. So we're trying to help them out through the process as much as we can.
Yeah, they've done a great job so far. Everybody's been super humble, super in the mindset of like, yeah, I got a spot to earn. Nobody's coming in with a super big ego.
But I mean, I think all the rookies are great. I mean, I think the Spurs did an amazing job with the rookies that we have this year.
Game time! Game time! Game time! Game.
9-4. Catch and shoot.
Side step.
You know, I didn't really start in Baylor, so it was pretty cool, but I think it was just, you know, excitement and an opportunity to show that I'm capable of playing and starting. I feel like I didn't get too excited or too nervous because I don't think that's really good for you. So I just stayed the course and, you know, I got the opportunity and I think I'm showing why I should start.
I mean, Jeremy's taking on any challenge he can find. Like, it doesn't matter who it is. It might be his matchup, might be somebody that's across the court. Like, he's just out there looking for trouble. But I like it. He's got that fighting spirit.
Yeah. I mean, well, Jeremy's, he doesn't have any fear. He's not impressed with the NBA or anything like that. He just comes to play. He loves the game. You can just see it on his face. You can see his body language. He loves being out there competing, and he does a great job of it.
He's having a good season. He's getting better every game. He's guarding the best players on the team. I know he's a little nervous guarding them, but at the same time, he's doing a great job guarding them. So.
Down by as many as 16 in this game. Boy. What a spin move! Sochan the Destroyer!
I'm not gonna lie, I don't know why, but I spaced out. Like, there was nothing in my brain. I spun because I felt the guy on top of me. I saw the like lane open up. I just went for it. I got high, so I had to throw in.
Have you had your welcome to the NBA moment?
I think, you know, guarding Curry was one of them. I think also there was one time against the Pelicans, Zion. I didn't even try to block his layup. I was just there to contest, and he's a big body, so he did drop me, and I fell, hit my head hard. But that was definitely a welcome to the NBA moment for sure.
Back to Branham, doesn't hesitate, and he shouldn't. He could be a sharpshooter, Malaki Branham, and the Spurs lead it by 10.
It was good just being out there, you know, since preseason. You know, that first game of your NBA career officially, you know, since, you know, I played preseason, that really don't count. So it was good. You know, since I haven't been playing, you know, significant minutes with the Spurs, you know, they just kind of decided for me to go to the G League, which is a, you know, a good choice, you know, I think, you know, for me to just get in-game reps, building relationships with them so, you know, they can trust me on the court. So it's been good. That was my first time meeting. Yeah, that was my first time. You know, he shouted me out a couple times, you know, committing to Ohio State and winning the state championship. But yeah, it was just cool meeting him, just seeing one of the best players to ever touch a basketball.
He can really shoot it. He can really defend. He's getting better. Pops on him, but that's a good thing. He wants him to do good. Playing both, he's going to get better down there. And then when he comes back, he's going even more better. So he's doing good. This is my opportunity to go out there and show them what I got, because everybody going to have an opportunity. Everybody gave me a hug, telling me about good job, way to execute, way to do the little things, way to get others involved. Keldon called me over and said, good job, we need that.
It's so crazy just having to talk with him earlier today in the locker room and just telling him just stay solid, keep the basics, because that's what keeps you on the court. And he did an amazing job. He hit some open shots, made some plays.
It's a lot of games, and I think it's been all exciting, and it hasn't felt like a job or anything. I think it's just, you know, having fun and playing basketball is a game I love. And I think, you know, I think it's exciting what the future can, you know, hold for me, but also, you know, the team. So I think it's gonna be a lot of fun.